my name is Anne Charlotte Robinson, and my BRVGS senior project is psychology, the effects of COVID-19 on mental health. So unlike many of my classmates, I really had no idea what I wanted to do for my project. I had tossed around a couple of ideas, but none of them ever really stuck. It wasn't until I took AP Psychology in the spring of my junior year that I found a subject that I was really passionate about. Simultaneously, I was witnessing the toll that isolation and quarantine was taking on myself and my peers. So I combined these two things to create my project. So my quote of quality is, "Life doesn't make any sense without interdependence. We need each other, and the sooner we learn that, the better," by Eric Erickson. Now, Eric Erickson was a developmental psychologist, most known for his stages of psychosocial development. This ties directly into my project, as I am witnessing the effects of isolation and quarantine on the psychosocial development of adolescents. My research question was, how has the pandemic affected mental health of adolescents? And I'll jump right into my community service and internship. So for my professional learning experience, I interned with Ms. Christy Bonovich, who is the administrative assistant for BRVGS. She also focuses on student wellness. And as soon as I realized that she had a background in counseling, I reached out and we quickly established that it was a perfect match for my internship. Now, since she focuses on student wellness, she leads weekly community circles, which are basically like group therapy for the students, and sends out weekly Wellness Wednesday emails. For my hours, I was able to shadow and co-lead these community circles and also send out my own Wellness Wednesday email. And my topic was helping students to face challenges with a positive mindset and knowing that they can learn something from the situation and not being afraid to reach out to their community if they're struggling. And this picture here was from the kickoff event over the summer for new Blue Ridge students, and that was me leading a small group in a team building activity to help them get acclimated to the program. So for my community service, my mentor was also Ms. Bonovich, so I got to work very closely with her over the past year. I created Governor School Guides, which is a student mentoring program for BRVGS students. Basically, I pair an older student with a younger student based off of a survey that they fill out and return back to me, taking into account a little bit about their personality, their likes, their dislikes, and I make sure to pair students who I think will work well together and can even learn something from each other. I received great feedback from this program. 87% of the students said that it had a positive social impact on their lives, and 100% of the students would recommend that future students participate. And luckily that will be an option, as Ms. Bonovich has agreed to continue the program after I graduate, and I can't wait to see what she does with it. So along with my community service and internship, I was able to plan and lead a wellness conference in the fall for members of GSG. This definitely was a learning experience for me, as I had never done something like this before. I was able to get experience in event planning, as I had to plan out my agenda for the day and all the activities that I was going to do. And I also had to plan out a COVID-safe seating chart, making sure everyone was where they needed to be, following COVID guidelines. I also got experience in public speaking, which was never something that's really come easily to me, but this event really helped me prepare, even for this presentation. As soon as I stood up there and saw all those friendly faces, and I realized we were all just there for the same reason, and that was to reconnect with our fellow students and really foster that community within Blue Ridge, I felt extremely comfortable. So through my research, I have discovered that adolescents are suffering from stunted social development due to the years and months of isolation from their peers, and this psychological distress can last for up to 3 years after the initial stressor, which is why we must provide resources for these students in their high school career and as they move on into their young adult lives. This is extremely important that we support them, because this collective trauma that they've experienced will last for their entire life, and they will have to be coping with it, and we have to support them. My advice for future and current Blue Ridge students is to get started on your project early. I know it seems daunting, I was there, but if you can, by the end of your junior year, by the spring semester, if you can start making those initial contacts, reaching out to possible mentors, and setting up those hours, and getting the community service and internship knocked out by the end of the summer before your senior year, it will give you a lot more time in the fall to work on college applications, your classes, and your research paper. The research paper takes a lot of preparation and time, but if you do it correctly, the writing will flow easy. So that's definitely what I recommend, is just to get started early, and it'll help you feel in control of the entire process. And my future plans are, I will be attending East Tennessee State University in the fall as a global citizen scholar to receive my Bachelor's of Science in Psychology, and eventually go on to graduate school to receive my doctorate in either clinical or school psychology so that I can continue to work with adolescents. And now I will open up for questions.